I'm Karyn Sherar. I'm a pediatric nurse practitioner. I work at Lowell Medical Center here at Mercy, and I'm here to answer a few questions that moms have posed on the website. And one of those questions was about temper tantrums. Some moms are concerned about temper tantrums when they come into the clinic, and they want to know when will those decrease. And we all know what temper tantrums look like. Children can become frustrated when they're small. They get frustrated very easily. They may throw themselves down on the floor, kick and scream, get very frustrated. And it's sometimes helpful to put yourself, if you've been in a frustrating situation, for instance, if you can't program your VCR, you've got the book out and you've worked at it for about an hour, you may stomp off, throw the book, swear, whatever. Well, children have frustrations as well. In the toddler age, oftentimes they understand speech more quickly than they can actually express it. They may have a lot of pent-up feelings and they just can't get that out or be able to express it very well. So they get very frustrated and then they'll start to melt down. One way to help small children with this is to give them as many choices as you can. If it's over a food item, you know, say, would you like an apple or an orange today? If it's a small toy you're purchasing, you know, try to give them as many choices as you can. If there's truly something that you don't want them to have, it's important to keep that out of sight so that won't be so frustrating. Choose your battles very carefully. It's very important, of course, as far as safety goes. You need to be very strict with that if they're being unsafe. But other things, I think it's important to have a little bit of give and take with your toddler. You need to know your child's limits. If you're having a long day and you need to go by the grocery store, run a few more errands, and your child is tired, and you know that he's starting to get frustrated and melt down, it's not a good time to continue to do other errands. It's better just to go home and let him take a nap. As far as when a tantrum actually occurs, you know, in the past people would say, oh, you just need to walk away and ignore it. But I do think you need to stay with your child. You need to make sure he's not injuring himself. You don't necessarily need to pick him up, but you need to be, say, comforting words. Encourage him to calm down, and it's important for you to stay calm yourself and not get frustrated. If you have an older child that's having a meltdown, yelling, hollering, it's important for them to go into their room and set a limit with them and say, you need to stay in your room until you have calmed down. After the tantrum is over, you need to pick them up, hug them, and say, I'm really glad you're back in control now. And that's a very comforting thing. As far as if you have any questions about any further things and you feel like things are getting out of control, these are times when you need to discuss this with your pediatrician. If your child's having a lot of temper tantrums, they're escalating, they're getting worse, you find that you're getting very angry yourself, that's a time that you need help from a provider, a nurse practitioner or a physician, to discuss that. If your child is being destructive, hurtful to other people, if he's you know, tearing up objects in your home, then that's another reason that you might come in for help. If the tantrums are increasing in frequency or duration or intensity, that's another time you need to seek help. Sometimes when you come in to see your healthcare provider, when they do a well visit, it's a good time for us to really review their development. Sometimes kids can have more tantrums if they have learning disabilities, if they have hearing or vision problems, language delays, any chronic illnesses. So that's a good time to discuss those things when you're there for a well visit. So if you have any further questions, feel free to contact us at Lowell Medical Center, and have a good day.